subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Hi friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see what is profit loss and what are the important problems of profit and loss, and what are the important formulae of profit and loss. All these things we are going to see in this video. So now let's begin this video without any delay. So coming to the profit and loss, first we need to learn what are the basic formulae which will be helpful and useful to solve any kind of problems. First we need to know how to find the profit of any product, okay? So if there is a problem and if they give a problem and if they ask us to find what is profit, then here is the formula which will be helpful. That okay, then you need to use this formula. In order to find what is profit, we need to subtract selling price and cost price. Selling price minus cost price. Okay, selling price can be denoted as SP. Cost price is denoted as CP. Profit is denoted as P. P is equal to SP minus CP. That is, if you subtract the selling price and cost price, then we will be getting profit. And other important thing is, profit is also called as gain. Okay, profit is also called as gain. So this is first important formula. If you wanted to find profit, you need to subtract selling price and cost price. Now let's see how can we calculate, how can we find loss. Okay, loss is also very easy. When we subtract cost price and selling price, then we get loss. Let's denote loss as L, cost price as CP and selling price as SP. When we subtract cost price and selling price, we will get loss. Okay, remember this point. In profit, selling price will be more, and from selling price we will subtract cost price. But in loss, cost price will be more and selling price will be less. Okay, so now let's see what is selling price and cost price. Okay, selling price, the price at which the product is sold is called selling price. Okay, the price at which the product is sold is called selling price. Next, what is cost price? Cost price, in the name itself they are saying, the cost of the product is called cost price. Okay, so now let's see how can we calculate gain percentage. How can we calculate gain percentage? Okay, so what is the problem, what is the formula for calculation of gain percentage? Gain by CP into 100, that is gain by cost price is cost price into 100. Okay, now what is the formula for loss percentage formula is also very easy. Loss divided by cost price into 100. Okay, so either it is gain percentage or loss percentage, denominator will be same, into 100 is same, only the numerator will be changed. Okay, in gain percentage, gain divided by CP into 100. In loss percentage, loss divided by CP into 100. Okay. In denominator, commonly there will be only CP. Okay. Clear till here? If you want, you can just take the screenshot. So coming to the next formula. Now let's see what is the formula for selling price. Okay, so what is the formula for selling price? Selling price is equal to Selling price is equal to 100 plus gain percentage divided by 100 into cost price. Okay, 100 plus gain percentage divided by 100 into cost price. This is selling price when there is a gain. Okay, so now let's see what is the formula for selling price when there is loss. Loss is also very easy. The formula for loss is also very easy. 100 minus loss percentage divided by 100 into CP. Okay, we did nothing. Instead of plus, we wrote minus. Instead of gain percentage, we wrote loss percentage. That list, rest all, it's same with the formula. Okay, so now let's see what is the formula for cost price. Okay, formula for cost price when we get gain or when we get loss. First, let's see for gain. It is very, very easy. I'll tell you how to remember the formula. Consider this formula, okay? Because first we are considering for gain, okay? So consider this formula and take the denominator and write as it is. We just took the denominator and wrote in numerator side, on numerator side, and numerator we are writing in denominator side, okay? 100 plus gain percentage into, clear till here? We just did nothing. The denominator side we wrote on numerator side and vice versa. We took this numerator and wrote it on the denominator side. Clear till here? Into here there is CP, so logic here we are writing SP, selling price. Easy. So this is the cost price formula when we get gain. Now let's see what is the cost price formula when we get loss. Same. Take this denominator and write on numerator side, divided by numerator side comes down, which is denominator 100 minus loss percentage into CP becomes SP. That's it. So like this, logically we can remember the formulae. So now let's start solving problems from profit and loss. Let's see this question. The question is, the cost price of 20 articles is same as selling price of X articles. Then find X. Okay, so what are they saying? Cost price of 20 articles is equal to selling price of X articles. Okay, then find X. This is the question. Okay, so now let's see how to solve this problem. So first, what we are doing is, let cost price of each article be rupee 1. Okay, so we know what is the cost. So cost price of 20 articles is equal to selling price of X articles. What is X? This is the question. So first, let's assume, let Let cost price of each article be rupee 1. Okay, here what we are assuming, we are just assuming cost price of one article is rupee 1. Okay, so how many products we have X? Then cost price of X articles will be how much? X articles will be rupees X. Clear till here? We are just assuming cost price of each article is rupee 1, but here we have X articles, so cost price of X articles is rupees X. But here, what are they saying? Then what is selling price of X? Okay, what is the selling price of x? It is 20 rupees 20. Cost price of x articles we assumed as x, because we assumed cost price of each article, that is one article is rupee 1, then the cost price of one article is rupees 1. So obviously when there are x articles, the cost price of x articles will be rupees x. Clear till here? Now in the question they gave selling price of x. We need to find selling price of x. What is equal to selling price of x? Cost price of 20. 20 articles. See, when one article rupee is 1, so when we assumed one article price as rupee 1, then cost price of 20 articles will be rupees 20. Clear till here? So here we know the cost price and we know the selling price. Now let's find what is the profit. And we know the formula of profit also. Selling price minus cost price is the profit. What is selling price? Selling price is nothing but rupees 20 minus cost price is x. Okay. So profit is equal to 20 minus x. And in question, they also gave profit percentage is equal to 25%. Okay. In question only they gave this. So profit percentage is equal to 25%. We all know this. And we also know what is the formula for profit percentage. Profit percentage formula is profit value 20 minus x. Profit is nothing but selling price minus cost price, right? So we wrote it directly. Selling price minus cost price divided by selling price minus cost price divided by cost price into 100. Okay. Into 100. And we know what is the profit percentage. Profit percentage is 25. So clear till here? Now we need to solve this. Okay, divided by cost price. What is cost price? X into 100. And in question they gave profit percentage. What is profit percentage? 25. So we have written it directly. So now we need to solve this equation. Okay, now let's solve this. 20 into 100 is 2000. 20 into 100 is 2000 minus x into 100 is 100x divided by x, denominator we are writing as it is equal to 25. Clear till here? Okay. 2000 minus 100x divided by x is equal to 25. This is prof. We are finding this. Okay. So now our goal is to find the. In question we are asked to find the value of x. So we are doing the same. So next we are writing the same thing. 2000 minus 100x. Is equal to x we are sending to right hand side, so divided by x when it goes to right hand side becomes into x. Okay, 25 into x is 25x. So we need to solve this. 2000 is equal to 25x minus 100x when it goes to right hand side it becomes plus 100x. Okay. Plus 100x. Now 2000 is equal to 25x plus 100x is 125x. Okay. So x is equal to 2000 divided by 125, and 125 ones are 125, 16s are 2000. Okay, so x is equal to 16. So what is the question? They are asking us to find x. So we finally found x. X is equal to 16. In a store, profit is 320% of cost. If cost increases by 25% and selling price constant, then what percent of selling price is the profit? This is the question. So first, let's see what they are asking. So first, let's see what is the question. In a particular store, profit is 320% of cost, it seems. Profit is 320% of cost. Okay. And next, cost increases by 25%, but selling price is constant. Then what is the question? What percentage of selling price is profit? This is the question. So now let's see how to solve this problem. Okay. So coming to the solution, first let's assume cost price is equal to rupees 100. Okay, because we don't know the exact cost price. So let us assume cost price is equal to rupees 100. Okay, so we are just assuming cost price as rupees 100. What will be the profit? Profit will be rupees 320. How? Because profit is 320% of cost. Okay, so we assumed cost price is 100 rupees. So on this, 320% is profit. So 100, 320% of 100 is 320 rupees, right? So profit is rupees 320. Clear till here? And see how we got 320 rupees. Okay, so in the question they clearly gave profit is 320% of the cost. Okay, clear till here? 320% of cost. 320%. So 320 divided by of cost. What is the profit? What is cost? 100 into 100. How much? Like this, we need to find the profit. Okay, see, I'm telling you again. Profit is 320% of the cost. 320% divided by cost. What is the cost? We assumed cost price as 100 into 100 is equal to 320. So we found the profit, which is rupees 320. Which is rupees 320. Okay. But we don't know what is selling price. They are saying selling price is constant, but we don't know what is selling price. What is selling price? First, let's see what is the formula for selling price in order to find the exact value of selling price. Okay. Selling price is equal to, what is the formula for selling price? Selling price is equal to cost price plus profit. And we know the value of cost price and profit. Cost price value is rupees 100 plus profit value is rupees 320, which we just found out. Okay. So 100 plus 320 is rupees 420. So we have found out selling price, which is rupees 420. Clear till here? But here, see the question. They are saying what percentage of CP is profit? Means in selling price, how much percentage is profit? So this is the question. So this is the question. So first note down what we found. We know the cost price, which is rupees 100. We found out profit, which is 320. We found out selling price, which is 420. Okay. Clear till here, right? So now the question is, what percentage of selling price is profit? Means in this selling price, How much percentage is profit amount? This is the question. We know what is selling price, profit, and cost price. Clear till here. But see, what are they saying? If cost increases by 25%, it seems, means cost price increased by 25%. So what is the cost price? 100. On that, what is the cost price which we assumed? It is 100. But they are saying cost price increased by 25%, and on that 100%, 25% increased. So it is 125%. Okay. In 100%, 25% increased. So totally it is 125%. So 125% of 100 is 125 rupees. So updated cost price is 125 rupees. Okay, so this is latest updated cost price. Okay, because in question they clearly gave cost increased by 25%. Okay, so 125% of 100 is rupees 125. Okay, clear till here. Now what we need to do, they are asking what percentage of selling price is profit. We should first find out profit, and then we need to find what percentage of selling price is profit. Okay, we all know what is formula for profit. Profit formula is selling price minus cost price. Selling price we all know, which is 420, minus cost price formula is updated. So now we just need to forget this old selling price which we assumed, because we found out the latest cost price. What is latest cost price? It is 125, because 25% increase, assumed the cost price is 100, on that 25% increased, so it became 125. Okay, so profit is equal to 420 minus 125 is nothing but 295. Okay, 295. Clear till here? Now what we need to do is, now in question they are asking what is the percentage, what percentage of selling price is profit. Okay, so now we need to find out the percentage. We all know the percentage formula. Percentage formula is profit divided by selling price. Profit divided by selling price into profit divided by selling price into, we just need to substitute the values. We know the profit value. What is profit value? 295 divided by, what is selling price value? Selling price value is 420 into 100 percentage. Okay, so when we solve this, we will be getting 70%. Okay, so 70% of SP is profit. Okay, so now what is the question? A vendor brought 6 toffees for rupee 1. Okay, so for 1 rupee, vendor brought 6 toffees. Okay, so now what is the question? How many toffees vendor need to sell for rupee 1 to get 20% of profit? Okay, so how many toffees vendor need to sell for rupee 1 to get 20% profit is the question. Okay, so now let's see how to solve this problem. Okay, so what is the cost price? Cost price of 6 toffees is rupee 1. What is cost price? Is like the price at which we purchased the product. Okay, so the price of the product is nothing but cost price. Okay, so the cost price of 6 toffees is rupee 1, right? So what should be the selling price? Selling price, he need to get 120% of rupee 1. What does this mean? I'll explain you. See, let us think here the cost price is 100%. Okay, cost price is 100%. Okay, in question, what is he telling? How many toffees the vendor need to sell in order to get 20% profit? Okay, 20% profit means what? Cost price 100 plus 20% profit. So at 120%, he need to at 120% of the cost, he need to sell the product, because see, cost price is 100%. Like, for this much price, the product was bought. Okay, for this cost price, for the amount which he bought, he is adding 20% profit and making the price as making the selling price as 120%. Okay, selling price of six toffees will be 120% of rupees 1. Okay, 120% of rupee 1 is 120% of rupee 1 is equal to how much? When we solve this, we will get 6 by 5. Okay, for 1 rupee, 6 toffees he bought, right? What is 1 rupee? 1 rupee means 100 paise. Okay, for 100 paisa, he brought 6 toffees. Right, for 100 paisa he brought 6 toffees, but now he need to get 20% profit. And how many toffees he need to sell? But now the question is, how many toffees he need to sell to get 20% profit? This is the question. 20% of profit is nothing but then selling price will be 120. We already know that, right? We already know that, because see, when he bought with 100 pais and he need to get 20% profit, then 120% of 100 pais is 120 pais. So he need to sell six toffees at 120 paisa. Okay, he need to sell toffees at 120 pais. Okay, so this is the logic. Okay, so if he wanted to get 20% profit on 100 paisa, he need to sell toffees for how much? 120 paisa. Okay, so he need to sell 5 toffees for rupees 1. So this is the problem. For 100 pais, he brought 6 toffees. Then if he wanted to get 20% profit on 100 pais, then he need to sell for 120 pais. Okay, for 120 pais, how many toffees he need to sell is the question. So we just need to do a cross multiplication. Let this be x. Okay, x is equal to, x is nothing but number of toffees. How many number of toffees he need to sell? Okay, x is equal to 100 divided by 120 into 6. Okay, 2 5s are 10, 2 6s are 12. Okay, 2 5, we are just doing the cross multiplication, nothing else. And we got 5 divided by 6 into 6. 6 6 gets cancelled and x is equal to 5. What is x? X is number of toffees to be sold to get 20% profit. So he need to sell 5 toffees for rupee 1 in order to get profit of 20%. Okay, so yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.